let's just hope that our kids are more evolved than we were.
A lot of questions coming in about the Cobra Kai series. A lot of people watching it. It's popular. I remember watching it when it was on YouTube Red, which was a long time ago, and now it was bought and it's become big. I remember, as you guys out there old enough remember, the original Karate Kid series with Miyagi and Daniel-san, and we saw that at the movies in the 80s. Great cultural movie, and I like that they're bringing it back, and they're actually doing it justice. It's well written, pretty well acted. But, Mr. Norcross, how are the fight scenes in it? Are they realistic? No, of course not. Not as they were in Bruce Lee movies or Shokosugi or Steven Seagal. It doesn't matter what movie you can pick. The movies are not there to make the fight scenes look real. Most, high 90 percentages. The story is what carries Cobra Kai and the characters. Fight scenes are peppered in for fun, and they're by no means reality-based. What I don't like about those fight scenes, and again, I like the series, I highly recommend it, is the anger. There's so much anger behind these kids fighting, and of course, it's not realistic. I just saw one of the scenes, I don't know what season three, I guess. Kids thrown through a plate glass window, gets up, continues to fight, and, you know, none of that's real. The kid would have been in the hospital, the police would have been called 30 seconds in. Instead, you have 25 kids fighting in someone's kitchen over a girl and boyfriend dispute. It's ridiculous, of course. But that's not the point of it. The point is to suspend reality. It's not like you see here. You see the mats behind me. We used those last night, the night before, and the night before that, and there are targets all along there. Martial arts is sweat and blood and tears and real hard work. Martial arts is something that goes away over time. It is a diminishing skill, and these actors, and they all know that, because now you see them in interviews and they've lost that skill because you know, they were rehearsing these fights for weeks and weeks on end. Yes, I like the fights. I don't like how they're all about anger and jealousy and frustration. They're not about the real purpose of martial arts, which is to defend yourself and not have to show it, and to talk your way out of it and use your humor like Miyagi did as best you can. But again, that's me saying it as a sensei. But if it can inspire you, that's the point. If Cobra Kai inspires you to go out and join a dojo, wonderful, do that. Find a local karate school, taekwondo, MMA, judo, budo, ninjutsu, whatever it is, and have fun. I was inspired by Bruce Lee movies and Shokosugi movies, all of those, to go out and train. Kwai Chang Kang, way back when it was called Kung Fu on the television. And that inspired me to go to my local dojo, which wasn't easy. It was 45 minutes away. But I did it, and I'm still doing it 40 years later. One of you out there watching will be inspired by Cobra Kai. You will go to your dojo. You will have your fantasies destroyed immediately on the mat in your delusions, because it is not like you see in Cobra Kai. It's a lot of hard work, blood, sweat, and tears. And you'll have ups and downs in your training. And most high 90% of all of you who join a martial art will quit. That's just the reality of it. But a couple of you watching won't. A couple of you watching will be inspired by Cobra Kai, and in 5, 10, 20, 30 years, you will be the next Miyagi at your local dojo, because you'll be the only one that stuck with it. When all the others walked away because it got too hard and difficult, you might be the one that runs your own school one day and can really bring martial arts to your community. Understand that all movies are about making money. The producers want to make money. They don't care about the fight scenes. They focus more on the writing, the actors, what will bring in the largest crowds. Fight scenes are fun. They're highly choreographed. They're not real. They're messy, which I do like about the fights in Cobra Kai. They're really messy, and that's how a fight is. Very little grappling. Some realistic stuff as far as punching and kick. You know, a block is a block. But most of it's not real, of course. We know that. You know that. But know that if you do join a real dojo, you will be disappointed at some point, because it's really hard. But if you stick with it, you might be one of the few that actually gets to a high level where you can open your own school. And the point of martial arts is not, like they do, to fight in anger and jealousy over a boy or girlfriend dispute. It's about protecting other people and not having to use your martial arts in the lowest form, which is the physical. Use it in the mental form all day long. Use it in the spiritual form all you want. Stop a fight with your your intellect first, your voice second, your fists and feet should be the last possible way to stop a fight. So if Cobra Kai inspires you, great. I like the show. I highly recommend it. I love how they're changing the antagonist and protagonist around. The acting's fun. They're doing justice to Miyagi. All the old characters are coming back and making me feel like I'm 10 years old again. I love it. No, it's not real, nor are any movies, but they're there not to be real, but to inspire us to go out and find the real martial arts. And hopefully you will. Everybody have a great day. Enjoy the series. And if you are training at a real dojo somewhere, continue. Don't quit. The benefits highly outweigh the disappointments. We'll see you guys soon. I'm going to go and get ready to train because we have classes in an hour. Have a great day. Bye-bye.